Let's assume that we have this parquet here and we want to create some scratches or some imperfection effects on them. There are some maps on the internet, but if you are using paid websites, you can use Polygon website. I have a great website with different maps. I have the collection here. I will upload some of them just for your exercise in my Patreon files, but not all of them. But you also can find them in other websites too. For some advanced rendering engines like Unreal Engine or other kind of engines, for example, V-Ray, we also can use overlay maps and also normal maps of imperfection effects. But for this, for Revit, we just can use our default maps. Let me select this floor here and let me go to the, I'm going to select the floor here, not the curtain or glasses. Let's go to the edit tab, and from here let's go to the edit and let me modify the appearance here. And in the bump place, you need to assign your imperfection. And I said earlier, the minus point here, the minus point of this method is that you only can use one bump maps. So if you have a material that where the bump maps are very important, you can do this in Revit, unfortunately. But for some materials like this parquet, bump maps isn't doing anything here, so I can replace it easily. For example, I have some maps here. Let me see some of them. You can see the maps. These are the main maps that I'm going to use, these black ones, and with different effects. Let me assign this one, or assign this one, it's not very different, and just drag it to here. And let me click on apply. And now let me put it on higher number, but make sure it is under 500, because more than that, it will the Enscape will recognize this map as a displacement. You can see some change right now. You can see some scratches here. It will be more visible in lights. But let me change some. Let me change some things here. For example, let me put it on invert image. Click on done and done. You can see more differences here when you put it on invert image mode. But let me put it on lower number. This is not really good for a modern house. And let me click on apply. And you can see the effects, but it is, let me put it on maybe 200. Click on apply and you can see the scratches. The amount of that and the effect is in your hand and you can change it at any time. And also if you want to create a scratch for just one area of this parquet, you need to use a split face and assign and duplicate this material with one of them with no scratch effects and one of them with scratch effects, and assign the scratch effects to here and assign the material with no scratch effects to the other places. Okay, that was it. And let me try another one here. Maybe this. And also you have some other maps here, maybe dusts or something else, but it is not really working as good as scratches in Revit, because we are using them as a bump, so we just can use scratches in here.